this piece of meat has all the goodness, has all the juices of the pulao. That's a piece of chicken that's big in flavors.
We are on Cotton Pet Main Road here in Bengaluru, and we are here to lunch at an establishment that lays claim to a culinary legacy of over 100 years. We are here at New Govind Rao Military Hotel.
So I'm here with Mr. Kishore Kumar, who is the owner of New Govind Rao Military Hotel. So, ಏನ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಇದೆ ಇದು ಮಿಲಿಟರಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್, ಏನು ಯಾಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನರು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ?
ಸರ್, ಇದು 111 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಹೋಟೆಲ್.
ಓಕೆ.
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಓಲ್ಡೆಸ್ಟ್ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್.
ಓಕೆ.
ಸಿನ್ಸ್ 1908 ಈಸ್ ದ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್. ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅವರ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಗೋವಿಂದ ರಾವ್ ರಣ್ಣವರೇ. ಇಡ್ಲಿ, ಪಾಯಾ, ಸೊಪ್ಪು, ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ, ಚಿಕನ್, ಮಟನ್. ಚಿಕನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 4 ತರ ಐಟಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟರ್ಸು. ಮಟನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 5 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ, ನೋ ಟೇಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೌಡರ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್. ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿಗೆ ತೀರಾ ಹೆಲ್ತಿ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಜೊತೆಗೆ ತುಂಬ ರೀಸನಬಲ್ ರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಜನ ತುಂಬ ಇಷ್ಟ ಬಿದ್ದು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಕಿಶೋರ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೀ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಗೋವಿಂದ ರಾವ್ ಮಿಲಿಟರಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ವೆರಿ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ಕಲರ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಪ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ 110 years. Secondly is the use of the ingredients that are still maintained, that are still prepared in the same way that they used to decades ago. So idu beliga andre eshtu 6 gante start agutte,
6:30 morning Tuesday to Saturday. Sunday 5:30 morning open agutte.
Okay.
Up to 10:30 varuku open irutte.
All right. The eatery opens at 6:30 in the morning, but we are here at 1 o'clock, 1:45 actually, so we are here just in time for lunch. But before we sit at the table, I want to take a quick peek at the kitchen and see how they prepare the food here at New Govind Rao Military Hotel. Sir, kitchen nodboda?
Bani
sir. So the pulao here is interesting. So they cook the rice separately with the masala in that pot here, and then they cook the meat also separately with,
yes,
the masala.
Yes.
And the stock of the meat,
yes,
is then added to the pulao, which lends it all that flavor. So this is a mix of fresh herbs, there's some spinach, some pudina, which is coriander. So adu oily ga hogutte.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oil mix. Bere enide
pudina ella tara kotmiri pudina vaka idu karbe soppu,
karbe soppu, curry leaves.
Yes.
Chilli
second barutte,
second adke barutte. Okay, fine. So now this will go into the hot oil.
Yeah.
So there is also some turmeric that is going in.
Yeah, turmeric.
So the herbs have gone into the pot and I can smell all those aromas. Next, I'm told that the mutton sherwa or a mutton stock with spices will go into that urn that will shortly have the rice. So there you go, that's the mutton sherwa. So andre idella nati padarthagalella. So I'm told that the ingredients that they use here are nati or local. And the sherwa has just gone into the urn with the green fresh herbs. So the pulao is well underway here at New Govind Rao Military Hotel. So in that pot there you have the green herbs, that is the spinach, the coriander, curry leaves and a few things that have gone in, followed by turmeric and then of course the robustly flavored mutton sherwa, which is the stock that is spiced and then put into that pot. We are now waiting for that mix to come to a boil. We've also added some water before the rice goes into that. I can already smell the aroma as I am standing here in this tiny kitchen of new Govind Rao Military Hotel. So what's interesting here is that the rice is cooked separately and the meat is cooked separately. So the rice and the meat do not necessarily meet each other when they're being cooked. And that's what makes the pulav here interesting.
You
did khaali pulav, right?
Plain
pulav. And then manually khaali pulav. So on the menu, you will also find an item called khaali pulav. And khaali pulav is nothing but the rice that is cooked with all the goodness of the herbs and the mutton sherwa. So the rice has all the flavor of the meat. Oh my goodness. So I'm told that is an Aid Seer Patre, which is, so Seer is basically a unit of measure that was used in the past. Just to provide some context, that urn there can feed 35 people, he says. Andre 35 munchidu kala janra iga iga kala janra
iga modla agidre bari 20 22 jana tinnaro iga more jana 35 jana tinnaro.
So he was telling me that these days people don't eat as much, so that's why it's about 30-35 people that you can feed, but in the good old days perhaps about 15-20 people would have eaten from that pot. So the rice is going into the pulao vessel,
Pulao pot,
as Mr. Kishore Kumar refers to it here. So the rice has gone in, and in about 9 or 10 minutes, that pulao will be ready for dum. So once the rice is ready, then it is kept on dum, and after which, before it is served, you have this liquid called paneer that goes on top of it for that aroma. Although you know, idu baruthe smell lage.
Very nice smell.
For that aroma, I can't really place what the aroma is. It certainly smells sweet. I can see the rice bubbling away in that pulav pot. ಈಗ ಬರೀ ಒಂದು ಮೂರ್ನಾಲ್ಕು ನಿಮಿಷ
ಹತ್ತು ನಿಮಿಷ
ಸೊ 10 ಮೋರ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪುಲಾವ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಡಿ ಸೊ ವೈಲ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪುಲಾವ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಕುಕ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ದಮ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನದರ್ ಪುಲಾವ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ರೆಡಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ರೈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪುಲಾವ್ ಪಾಟ್ ದ ರೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಫ್ಲೇವರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಗುಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮಟನ್ ಶೇರ್ವಾ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಗೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಲ್ ದ ಹರ್ಬ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪಾಟ್ ಲವ್ಲಿ As you can see, the mutton is ready, and the juice of this mutton is what makes for the sherwa, which goes into the rice. So when you order for the pulao here, you get the rice separate, and then you get the mutton pieces.
Yeah.
Is it, sir?
This is keema ball.
Keema ball.
Yeah.
Keema unde.
Yes, keema unde.
ಸೊ ಇದೇನು ಈ ತರ ಬೇಸರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಶೇರ್ವಾ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಶೇರ್ವಾ ಜೊತೆ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ
ಶೇರ್ವಾ ಜೊತೆಗೆ
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡ್ರೈ
ಡ್ರೈ
ಯಾರು ಡ್ರೈ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಡ್ರೈ ಕೊಡೋದು
ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕೀಮಾ ಬಾಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕೀಮಾ ಉಂಡೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಟ್ ಈದರ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇವಿ ವಿತ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ವಾ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸೊ ದ ಶೇರ್ವಾ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ಲಿ ದ ಗ್ರೇವಿ ದ ಮಟನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕುಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇದು ಚಿಕನ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಸರ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪೆಪ್ಪರ್ ಚಿಕನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅದು
ಇತ್ತು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಇನ್
ಅಪ್ಸ್ಟೇರ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ದ ಕಾಂಬೋ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಗೋವಿಂದ ರಾವ್ This is where we will come and eat. But before that, we'll take a look at the other kitchen, which is upstairs. We've already looked at the pulao kitchen downstairs. Now we'll look at the other kitchen upstairs. It's fascinating to see enterprises that exist in cramped spaces like this, but they've made the most of all the space that's available.
Sir,
he
is the Shivaji Rao.
Shivaji Rao.
Yeah. The main prepare all items.
ತುಂಬಾ ಖಾರ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ ಇದು
ಖಾರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸರೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಖಾರ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಖಾರ ತರ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ
ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಮಿಲಿಟರಿ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಿ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ ಚಿಕನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಆಲ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಚಿಲ್ಲೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್
Lovely. So this is the mutton gravy that gets served with the pulav. And this is also called the sherwa. This is the gravy that also goes into the rice as it's being cooked. I can smell the coriander in this. I can smell the spices that have gone into it. So you have the texture of the coconut as well. This is a flavorful gravy. Idralli solpa idsa ide alla solpa hulli limbe enu aktira. There's also some lime that's gone into it that's giving it a little bit of a tang. This is such a robust, fulsome gravy. Wow.
The chili is ready.
Wow, even that chicken chili is ready. Lovely. So I've got a piece of chili chicken just off the stove. Can see it's steaming hot. The masala in this chili chicken is certainly a spirited masala. Hello, roast martira idu.
Half oil
roast maadi aamele en martira idu grind martira. This gets roasted and then gets ground, and this is what the mutton, the meat is cooked in, and this is the base for that sherwa. So you've got chilies, you've got garlic, you've got ginger, you've got cinnamon, you've got a whole bunch of spices that have gone into this. So this is the starting point of the mutton pulav here. Having seen all the food that's being prepared here in the kitchens, I can't wait to go to the table and taste some of this.
So, mutton pulav ide, chicken pulav ide, chili chicken, pepper chicken, chicken fry, mutton chops.
So, agidre ondu mutton pulav, ondu mutton pepper dry, ondu mutton keema unde. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಲಿವರ್ ಇದೆ ಲಿವರ್ ಕೊಡಿ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ 3 o'clock ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಮೀ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಲಂಚಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇ ಓಪನ್ ಆಟ್ 6 ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ರನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ವೇ ಅಪ್ ಟು 10:30 ಎವ್ರಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಡೇ ಬಾರಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಮಂಡೇ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್
ಮಟನ್ ಪ್ಲೋ
ಮಟನ್ ಪುಲಾವ್
ಮಟನ್ ಕೀಮಾ
ಮಟನ್ ಕೀಮಾ
ಮಟನ್ ಲಿವರ್
ಮಟನ್ ಲಿವರ್
Chili chicken.
Chili chicken.
Pepper chicken.
Pepper chicken. Fantastic. That didn't take any time at all. In a few minutes, my patri with the mutton pulav and all these dishes is already here. Ide, you know?
Gravy.
Oh, this is the sherwa. Lovely. Thank you. So I've got my lunch patri here at New Govind Rao. So of course I have my mutton pulav which is right here. Then I have the Kheema Unde, the mutton mince. Staying with mutton, we also have the mutton liver. And then we have the chicken pepper dry. And also the chili chicken. This is the chili chicken that we saw being prepared upstairs. And then of course if you need to perk up the flavors a bit more, you have the gravy. I can't wait to taste this pulav. The pulav feels warm to the touch. This is the short grain rice that's used here in this pulav. The first bite, only the rice. This is a pulav that's quite fulsome in its flavor. So you definitely taste that mutton stock that's gone into it. Each grain of rice has swelled with the goodness of the mutton stock that's gone into it. So typically if you ask for the pulao here, you just get served the rice, but the rice is already cooked in the mutton stock. And because I asked for the mutton pulao, you also have the pieces of meat which is there with the pulao. Let's taste a piece of the meat. Now this is not a pulao where the meat is juicy, succulent. It's a robust sort of a pulao. The flavor is definitely in the rice. Let's taste this with a bit of the gravy. So that's the sherwa or the gravy that the mutton is cooked in, with all the spices, with all the masala. You definitely need this gravy for the pulao to come alive. You know, this is a pulao that grows on you. So I must be honest, when I had the first bite, I wasn't really blown away. But as I'm tasting the pulao and as I'm tasting it with the gravy to moisten it, now the pulao is coming onto its own. Let's now taste the pepper chicken dry. It's got some chili as well here. You can taste the pepper for sure, and some of the spices. Perhaps there's also a hint of coriander here that the chicken is fried in. This is a great chicken dish. Next, we're going to go for the chili chicken. This was the chicken that was being prepared when we were upstairs in the kitchen. Let's taste this. You got all that thick chili gravy. This is the chili chicken military style. As you can see, that chicken is coated in all that chili chicken masala. That chicken is tender to the bite. I got a piece of the meat that's coated in all the masala. You know, I was expecting this to be a lot spicier, but it's not really as spicy as that. You definitely have that chili heat, and I know I'm sweating at the back of my head, but it's not insanely hot. I'm gonna now go for the other mutton dish here, which is the Kheema Unde or the mutton mince balls. Get one of these right here and pour some of that gravy on top, just to drench that mutton mince ball, just to get the goodness of all those juices into that mutton mince. The mutton mince is very fine in its texture, and you have a bit of the fat or a bit of the sinews that you can also taste in this mutton mince ball. I think there's also some roasted gram flour that's binding the meat together here, which to a certain extent takes away from the meatiness of the mutton mince balls here. But quite a tasty dish nonetheless. What you need to do when you're eating here at new Govind Rao Military Hotel is to keep going back to that pulao. I'm beginning to like the pulao the more and more I eat it. It's not a pulao that will blow you away at first sight. It's not a pulao that will knock your socks off. But as you eat it, you begin to realize that this is a satisfying pulao in its own right. This piece of meat has all the goodness, has all the juices of the pulao. Next, we're going to go for the mutton liver. just get some of that masala onto the piece of liver. I want the liver to soak up all that goodness of the masala here. That's a piece of liver that's beautifully cooked. Delicious. This looks like a masala where the spices are well roasted. Fantastic. Oh, I love this. The mutton liver is cooked fine, but what really makes a difference are the spices. You can feel the mellow heat of the spices that have gone into this mutton liver. So if you're in Bengaluru and you love your non-vegetarian food, do check out New Govind Rao Military Hotel for a taste of non-vegetarian Uta served local style. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!